Welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, my name is V. I am a fully qualified actuary. I have been in the industry for over 10 years now. Since I started this channel, I got a lot of questions about how is the actual job market. And today I will bring in an actual recruiter to answer this question for you. So let's get started.
Hi, Derek. Thanks for being here today. So can you tell us a little bit about yourself and the company DW Simpson?
Sure. Happy to be here. I am Derek Mulder. I'm a senior director at DW Simpson. I've been here for about 18 years. DW Simpson is one of the largest actuarial search firms in the world. We've been around for over 25 years. In 2018, Forbes named us a top recruiting firm in the country, and as was voted on by the companies that we work with. So obviously pretty proud about that. We have about 10 recruiting teams, and most of our employees have been here for over a decade. So a large group of experienced recruiters at DW Simpson.
So from your experience and insight, what is the actual job market outlook?
I think the outlook is great. Obviously with the pandemic last year, it was tough, like most industries were. So it was a struggle, and you know, companies put jobs on hold and candidates didn't want to move. Rightfully so. We were going through something that we'd never been through. So it was extremely difficult. And then turn the calendar year and we've really seen a large uptick in the number of jobs. All the different levels of jobs are back. And it really looks like the actuarial world hiring world is coming back, and we're pretty excited about what the future holds.
The insurance industry and then other industry in general changed so much with like different trends in technology and social trend and everything. Has that impact the actual job market? And if so, in what way? Are there any roles that are in higher demand?
Well, I think you hit it there. The technical skills of an actuary are becoming super important for nearly every role that we're working on right now, whether it's just to have some exposure to some of the modeling platforms or to know how to program. Across the board, a lot of companies are asking for very strong technical skills. And I think that that's kind of morphed from the more traditional actuarial position, which there still are plenty of those types of roles. There's a lot of roles that are combining both analytical, technical skills along with the actuarial background.
Do you have any observations on the role of like an actuary in the non-traditional jobs like analytics or data science?
Sure. And that is something that has really grown quite a bit. If you know how to work with data, if you know how to manipulate data, if you know how to dive into data, there's definitely a seat somewhere for you. And, you know, some companies that we're working for are really looking for very strong R and Python. We hear about those two all the time, and in addition to others. Data science and analytics is how companies are saving money, how they are looking to move forward. And we are seeing a lot of demand for that. And we've seen actuaries that have been in more traditional roles, but maybe have some of that modeling experience, decide that this is the direction that they want to go in and become more of a data scientist. And those positions are certainly out there.
That's great to hear. So do you have any advice for job seekers, like maybe for the entry level or like the intermediate and then senior?
Well, yeah. And then I guess number one, be patient. It can take some time. Now I'll say that this market is very strong. So when you are ready to interview, make sure that you also have the time to do the interviews, because some of these positions can go very quickly right now, you know, especially when you're talking about the more advanced levels. There's a lot of competition for them, and more companies right now are open to remote work than we've ever seen. And that has really opened up the candidate pool for, filling these positions. I think as you're going through your job search, you know, find what drives you. And if you're in a position right now and you don't have a chance to work on predictive modeling, but you're interested in it, find an online course or a college course near you, just so you can gain that experience, put it on your resume, and it at least shows that you're interested in it. I would also say, as you're moving forward and getting close to something, don't settle for something just because it's a new opportunity. Make sure that it's something that'll truly make you happy, because moving from one tough situation to another tough situation is probably not the best thing to do. So make sure that when you do make that job move, that it's something that you're truly passionate about or that you know will make you happier than where you currently are.
Great advice. So next, can you tell us a little bit about the salary surveys that DW Simpson conducts?
So our salary survey, I'm just going to share my screen here. So this is on our website. And as you can see, we have different levels of the salary survey, from entry level, cap modeling, P&C, health, life, and pension. And within each of these, as you go through, you'll see they're broken out by students, folks still taking exams, and the designations that everyone has. What I'll say too is that we are in the process of revamping our salary survey. We are gathering quite a bit more data. We've gone to the market and asked for specific salary survey data from candidates. We're getting all that. We are going to be rolling out a newer version of the salary survey sometime in the fall, early fall, hopefully. And it's going to be interactive. And it's going to have a lot more data points, and it's going to be really accurate. We are also hopeful that sometime in 2022, that our salary survey will incorporate gender and ethnicity. And that's something that we're working on right now, too. So we're really looking to revamp this salary survey from where it is right here. And we're pretty excited about it. But as it stands right now, it's a great tool to look at where you are compared with other actuaries. We take the bottom 10% and the top 10% of salaries off, and these are the averages. So coming in the fall, it'll be interactive and it'll be really cool to use.
Oh, last question. Do you have any comments on the actual later stage career development, like maybe the path is to become senior leader, especially like C-suite?
We have seen it. And, you know, over the years, we've seen actuaries rise to CEO, CFO. And when that happens in an insurance company, the actuaries in that company feel very well taken care of. And it's a bright spot for actuaries. Those companies typically have an easier time getting new employees as actuaries, because they know that the person in charge understands what they do and has a vested interest in what they're doing. Even presidents of insurance companies. So as you're moving through all the exams and getting all this experience, it is completely possible at some point that you can be running an insurance company or an entire division of an insurance company. And that's probably pretty exciting for a lot of folks.
Yeah, that's great to hear. Yeah, so thank you so much for being here today and spending your time to talk about the actual job market and everything. So once again, thanks, Derek.
Oh, thanks so much for having me.
So that seemed like an exciting update about the salary survey that DW Simpson is going to have. I'm looking forward to know more details about like differences in gender, ethnics, and more. So we probably will have a video about the survey once it's released. And hopefully you also excited for that. About the actuary career entry level positions, I would say the salary depends a lot on the number of exams that you have and then your working experiences. But then once you become qualified, either like associates or fully qualified, at least for the fully qualified, I think we're talking about six-figure salary. And at that time, like the potential that how much you make would greatly depend on the positions that you're going to have at that point in time, because are you going to become, stay as a technical specialist, or are you going to go further and would like to become a people leader, going to middle management or senior management and even C-suite. So the potential or the growth there will be greatly depend on what positions you have at that point in time. Anyways, I hope that you know a little bit more about the actual job market, especially for the developed market in North America. And I will have someone to share insights for the actual job market in emerging market in Asia. So stay tuned for that. I wish you another happy, productive week ahead, and see you in another episode. Bye now.